Okay. What is a point that someone plotted for this graph? Josie?
1, -1.
1, -1. Anybody else get 1, -1? That sounds good. Sean, did you have another one?
No.
You had to have two. You gotta have another one at least.
I'm not sure if I read it right.
Okay, let's just see what you got. See if anybody else.
2, -3. 2, -3.
What do you guys think? Do we get 2, -3? Anybody else? All right. Sounds like we all agree. Okay, let's use those two points to start with. Just giving you a quick snapshot of how plotting these points goes, and we'll come back to this in a second. So 2, -3. And 1, -1. Right. And I'll go ahead and do the work up here. We'll just make triply sure that we have the points and we all agree. So we have a negative. Now, be careful, this negative does not apply to the square, okay? I guess not that it matters much, because when you square a negative, you get a positive. Well, let's see. Let me show you. So we plug a 1 in there, you square it, minus 5 times 1 plus 3. Okay, so this should actually come out to be a negative number, because we're not going to square the negative. The negative is outside of the square. It's just take that number and square it and get a negative as your answer, basically. So this is negative 1, 5 times 1, negative 5 times 1, negative 5 plus 3. Negative 5. Negative 1 minus 5 is negative 6, plus 3 is actually should be negative 3. Okay, so it should be negative 3. Question?
Yeah.
Ready? I don't really get how you did that negative thing, the square. Like, wouldn't it be negative 1 times negative 1?
No. So, x is this blank spot. Right, where we just plug numbers in there. That is what x is. Okay. If I wanted to take x, make it the opposite, right? Put a negative on it. So if it's negative, then it goes positive. It's positive, go negative. If I wanted that, I would have to put parentheses around the whole thing. Then I would include a negative in whatever number I plugged in for x. It's not the way it looks. Okay. And it comes down to simple order of operations. Right. Here's this number x. You can see you got two choices here. Multiply it by a negative 1, right? Or take it to the second power. What does multiplying by negative 1 or taking it to the second power come first?
Second power.
The second power comes first. Okay. So when we plug that number in for x, we square first, then multiply by negative 1. Does that make sense now?
Yeah.
So it's order of operations. Plug the number in for x, square it, multiply it by negative 1. If I wanted you to multiply by negative 1 before you square it, which can be done, we could do that again, we would have to have parentheses around the whole thing so that we force the order of operations to be different, right? To multiply by negative 1 first and then square. Okay? So, lesson learned there. We plug the number in, we square it first, the negative is still there, multiply positive 1 by negative 1, you get negative 1. Negative 5 times positive 1 is negative 5. Add your 3, you got negative 6 plus 3 is negative 3. So, this should actually be down here. Alright, let's do this again for 2. Plugging 2, that's 2. And that's going to be different, that's going to be different. Still going to add 3. 2. Okay, first we square the 2, then we'll multiply by negative. So 2 squared is 4. Multiply by negative 1, we have a negative 4. Negative 5 times 2 is negative 10. So we have negative 14 plus 3. Negative 11. So if I were to plot that as a point, that would be way down there. All right? Is anybody confused by that? I'm gonna ask you to do something very similar to that here in a second. So there are any questions about that? Negatives? How about let's do this? Let's plug in. This would be negative 11. Let's plug in a negative number. We'll plug in negative 2. Let's see what happens. I guess I should put a little comma, right? Then we'll figure out what the g value is, or the y value, if I'm thinking of it that way. So, negative, let's plug in a number for x. That number is negative 2. Negative 5 times x is negative 2 again, plus 3. The first thing we're going to do is take negative 2 and we're going to square it. It's going to be what? Negative 2 squared is
4.
4. Negative 2 times negative 2 is positive 4. But then we multiply by this negative, so we get negative 4. Negative 5 times negative 2 is? Good, positive 10 plus 3. 10 minus 4 is 6 plus 3 is 9. So negative 2, 9 would be the point we get there. How about you try? Try plugging in negative 3. Together, negative x squared minus 5x plus 3, plugging negative 3 in for x. So it's negative x squared minus 5 times x plus 3. If you write this stuff down, if you write down what I'm writing down right now, you'll make far fewer mistakes. Nobody thinks that you're cool because you do it in your head. If they do, they've got messed up standards. Okay? Nobody thinks you're lame if you write it down. Let's make sure we go slow, smooth, get things right the first time. So we plug negative 3 in there, negative 3 in there, negative 3 here. All right, negative 3 times negative 3 is positive 9, but there's that negative in front of that, okay? This is equal to the number 9, but then there's a negative in front of it, so it's negative 9. Negative 5 times negative 3 is positive 15 plus 3. So 15 minus 9 is 6, plus 3 is 9. Negative 3, 9. Any questions or concerns before you put everything away? Show me you can produce a couple of points just like that. Good to go? Ready? Okay, let's do it. Let's clear desks. Get a piece of paper, get a calculator. Okay, borrow one, make it quick though. So, to start with, I could, if I wanted to, I could do negative 2 plus 9, 7. Don't have to, it's going to all turn out to be the same. But probably most of you started with distributing this negative 4x, which is good. Negative 4x, both of these things. Negative 4x times negative 2 is positive 8x. Negative 4x times positive 3x is negative 12x squared. We added the 9 to the negative 2, so we don't have that anymore. Plus 5x. Let's see, we have a negative 12x squared. No other x squared terms to combine it with, so that's it. 8x plus 5x is 13x plus 7. If you have 13x minus 12x squared plus 7, that's the same. 7 minus 12x squared plus 13x is fine. All the same. If it's in a different order, it doesn't make a difference, just as long as those are the terms that you get. All right? So hopefully I'm going to look and I'm going to see just improvement over the last time. Are there any questions about that? Okay. We keep having this on homework review. We keep practicing until we improve and improve and improve. Next. Here's a function. I want you to plug these numbers in for x and then turn those into points on the graph. So we'll start with negative 1. So we got negative x squared minus 3x plus 1. So x is negative 1 right now. Plug those in. We have negative 1 squared. Negative 1 times negative 1 is positive 1. And we multiply by negative, so we have a negative 1. Does that all make sense? Did it confuse anybody? Go too fast. Good? Okay. Negative 3 times negative 1, positive 3. Plus 1, negative 1 plus 1, we just cancel each other out that way, and we're left with a 3. Just erase what we plugged in for x, we'll plug in something else. Plug in a positive 1. 1, 1, 1 squared is 1, negative 1 again. Now negative 3 times positive 1 is a negative 3, so we have a plus a negative 3. And negative 1 and positive 1 cancel each other out, so negative 3. Careful here, sometimes we get the x and the y confused, the x and the f confused. Okay. The x is negative 1, this is the x-axis, so that's where we show the negative 1. Here we have the f-axis, we can change this to the f-axis. Negative 1 is the x, 3 is the f, the y, and then we have 1, negative 3. 1 for x, negative 3 for f. All right? Any questions? Concerns? Okay? If you're in trouble with that, we'll just practice it again and get it again and just keep seeing improvement there. So now, let's talk about this graph right here. Let's pull out our notes, and we'll talk about functions and their graphs, and what all that means, and how it's not magical, beautifully logical. Answer this question. What does this point mean? Somebody I haven't heard from yet today. Blake.
Negative 1, 3.
Okay, negative 1. So that is important to give me two pieces of information, two numbers, a negative 1 and a 3 in that order. Okay. Now what does that point then with this negative 1 and 3 tell me? Just those two numbers. I mean, what's the importance of those two numbers? Might be even more simple than you think. Can you imagine all you saw was this graph and this equation here, this function. What would be the importance of this point with its numbers negative 1 and 3? What does it tell you? What information does it give you? Somebody new for today? You know what I've heard from Josie? You heard from Sean? That point that I was pointing to, negative 1, 3, in that order, what does that point with those numbers tell me about this function? Started. How about that point tells me that if, all right, Josie.
It tells you that if you plug in, for example, the negative 1, you know, they plug that number in,
mm-hmm.
and you know what came out.
Yes. Simple as that. If I plug in negative 1 into this function, what's going to happen is to do all this arithmetic, and 3 will be what all this boils down to, and therefore what f is. So if I input negative 1 into this function, the output will be 3. Okay? So what does this point tell me? Great?
Same thing, like plugging in 3 and get
Plug in what?
Plug in that input and get that.
Which input?
X or negative or a one.
A one, if I plug in one, I'll get.
Negative.
Okay. We have the beginnings of a graph. Okay. These two points are just two tiny parts of the whole graph. Okay? So let's talk about what this graph should look like. Do you think now that I have two points that I should just connect them with a line? Like that? Here's some mm-hmms and some mm-hmms and some mm-hmms. Sounds like we're not completely sure. Ready?
No.
Share your thoughts. Why?
Well, I think I remember, but you should go straight up and down, like linear or something.
You should go straight up and down.
I can't remember, but.
So I should go like this?
Yeah.
What about this point?
Same thing.
The same thing. I think I know what you're thinking of. Let's think about what this all means then. If this is the graph, if this is the graph for this function, let's think about what drawing these two lines tells us. First of all, a graph is made of a bunch of these points. Okay? This is really just like, if we didn't want to draw this line, we could just plug in a bunch of inputs and get out a bunch of outputs and get a bunch of points and plot all these points. And once we plotted a bunch of points, we start to see some shape take form. Okay. So let's think about this. If this is the correct graph, then there's a point right there. Agreed? There it is.
Yeah.
Where is that point?
One, seven.
Okay. Any thoughts about this point being at 1, 7, Sean?
It's related to -1, -3.
This point is related to 1, -3?
Yeah, because they both have 1 in it.
Okay, they both have a 1 as the input.
Yeah.
Hmm. So this one has an input of 1 and an output of -3. This one has an input of 1 and an output of 7. Josie, thoughts about that?
I don't think that's correct, because what you put in the input, you get specific output every time. So you get the exact same thing. If you put 1 in, you're going to get -3 every single time.
Do you hear what Josie's saying?
Yes.
Yeah.
If you plug in 1, you get what?
-3.
How often will you get -3 if you plug in 1?
Every time.
All the time, every time for this function, not every function, but this one. So what do you think about this point? Monica, it's wrong. Could it possibly be?
No.
Could it possibly exist for this function?
No.
No, it couldn't, because there's only one point with an input of 1. This couldn't possibly exist. And in fact, how many points do you think are on this line?
One.
If I draw a line, and I told you a minute ago that these graphs are made of a bunch of points, how many points would you have to plot over and over and over and over and over? This one and 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 this one. Until I make that line just by plotting points.
22.
You think that'll do it? Once I plot 22 points, then this line will look like a line and it won't look like a bunch of dots?
No.
How many points would I have to plot so that I have enough dots that just by plotting these dots, I wind up getting a line? Sean?
Two.
Two?
Yeah.
Let me plot 2 points. Here and there. Do those two points look like a line to me?
No.
Right now. Could I draw a line between them? Yes. But what I'm saying is, in order just by putting dots, put so many dots that it looks like a line.
Yeah.
How many dots would I have to draw?
An infinite
number of dots. Okay? So what I'm saying there is, there's an infinite number of points here on this line, and so what we're saying by drawing this line is there are an infinite number of outputs that you're going to get for plugging in 1. Basically, plug 1 into this function, and you'll get any number you want. Just find the dot that correlates with that f value, that output, and you have it, right? Do you want 5? There you go. Put in 1, you'll get out 5. You want negative 10? There. Plug in 1, you get -10. That's what this graph is saying, right? This graph's a liar. because it's not true. 1 goes in, negative 3 always comes out. Okay, get rid of all, I guess I could have left that scribbled. That, and that. Sean, you have some thoughts?
You were right the first time drawing the line straight through.
Okay, I was right the first time.
Because if you wanted a, let's say a, if you your input was 5, you'd have to like bring 5 down until you ran into the line, and that's the number you'd get.
Okay, so that'd be the output right there.
Yeah.
It looks like negative 12 or 13 or something like that.
And we can test that.
Let's test it.
With the function.
Let's test it with the function. Go ahead. Everybody test 5, right? Sean's saying, hey, look at that. I mean, now we're going to fix the problem. We don't have all these outputs for one input. Who's got it? Who plugged in 5 thinks they've got the right output?
I'm afraid I got 6.
6. We get any other 6s out there? We got a 6? 6? Okay, let's test it out. Negative 5 squared minus 3 times 5 plus 1. Remember, 5 squared, then negative. Square it, make it negative. Negative 25, negative 3 times 5, negative 15, plus 1. Negative 25 minus 15, where does that put us?
Negative 40.
Negative 40 plus 1?
39.
Negative 39.
Oh, no.
My word.
So it didn't work.
Do you think that this graph should be a line shape? Did I just draw it wrong?
Did I not quite make it steep enough?
Do you think if I drew it more perfect,
yeah,
that this guy at 5 would go through negative 39?
No.
If I drew a straight line, perfectly straight, like a laser beam, it would go through negative 39.
No.
So this graph must not be what? This graph that I've drawn must not be true, must not be correct for this function. Because this graph, this straight line, does not seem to have the points that match up with this function. See what I'm saying?
Yes.
This graph is actually made of all of the points that you ever plot. All the, put in all the inputs, get all the outputs for all those inputs, and plot all those points against those inputs and outputs. What will you start to see? Some kind of a shape, right? The shape of the graph that fits this function. And the shape that we're seeing right now does not seem like it should be. What kind of shape?
Straight line.
Straight line does not seem to work. Okay? And in, I mean, I found another point, right? What point did we just find? We found it together?
Five negative.
We gotta have that 5. 5 negative 39, I don't have enough room to plot that point. Okay? So, do you think if I go to 6, I'll have more luck?
No.
Seems like it's just taking a dive down towards the bottom, right? Okay? So maybe I should back up to maybe 4, try 4, see if it's up a little bit and I can plot that point, right? Maybe come back to 3, maybe come back to 2, 0, and so on. Almost time to go. What I want you to do is plot a bunch of points for this function. You already got it started, okay? Sort of, I took them from you. And see if you can figure out what shape it's supposed to look like. It's not a straight line, okay? So have a good day, leave that up there. Too bad.